Oh, hello. Thanks for joining me today in another program of Painting with TAli, your art collection. Today we are doing a Degas, a style in Degas. It's pronounced in French Degas, but it's really Degas, Degas. Anyway, he always painted like these ballerina girls, so I decided to do something modeled upon Nureyev, the male figure, in the Degas way or form or painting or whatever you want to do. Here, what I was deciding now is that is the color scheme. I want complementary blues with yellows and some in-betweens. So that's why I'm going with yellow right now. And okay, going with yellow right now. And I'm going to, I don't want a very bright yellow, so it has to be muted a little bit with a sienna, with a raw sienna. I want it muted a little bit with a raw sienna. I don't want it too bright. So Degas is very smudgy-like. Okay. Now, Degas did mostly in pastel, and I'm going to try to get a pastel effect about it, okay? I need the fuchsia. I need some fuchsia on it. Okay, smudge. Yellow it up again. And then on top of that yellow, a white. Watch the whites do a pastel tone to it. Okay, see? Okay, here we go. Okay. And then the waist. Okay, that seems to be fine. Now, that window out there is also yellow. As you can see, the window here in the composition We didn't do a drawing lesson today, but I can't do drawing lessons every single class, okay? Okay. Uh-huh. Okay, we have yellow for the window, and then some blotches of white will do just fine. Blotches of white, and a little bit of pink about it. A little bit of pink about it. Gives it a Degas feeling. Oh, okay, I'm gonna spend 200 years on this. Okay, the window is fine. Smudge. Life is beautiful when you smudge. So that complements with that. Now we need some blue. Okay. I'm gonna go with some blue, a little bit of violet. Because we want to tint this. Okay. Uh-huh. Yeah, and you know what? I want it even smudged up. Okay, that's doing fine. The rest of that wall has to be kind of complementary to it. God, what was that wall going to be? That wall was going to be a pinky. Uh-huh, that's what I want the wall to be. But smudged. Beautiful. How wonderful smudging can be. Nureyev did that movie, Valentino. I never really got to see the movie, Valentino. But unfortunately, he passed away from that dreadful disease, AIDS. And he was one of the greatest stars ever of the century. Okay, we got 17 minutes. Okay, I like that. His partner was Joan Fontaine, a great ballerina, older than him. She ended her career with him, and he began her career with her. Ballet is so beautiful. We don't get enough of it. Oh, and another thing, you know, a lot of parents say, oh no, I don't want my male child going into ballet because he's going to become a homosexual. That's not true. I know a lot of ballet dancers that are married to ballerinas, a lot of male dancers, and that has nothing to do. First of all, they're going to go out and do what they want to do, so you're not going to change them. You were a kid. You promised yourself, I'm going to go get what I want because they've always prohibited it from me. So when it comes to something as beautiful as ballet, I mean, I'd rather my daughter marry somebody, if I had a daughter, marry somebody who was a ballet dancer than a football player. Excuse me, really? I mean, what a football player, what's the reputation of football players, you know? Huh? Lately? So I don't like anything, I mean, I really don't think it's that wonderful, some kind of activity or sport that just furnishes violence. Okay. I have 15 minutes. Okay, I want a pastel effect about it. Okay. A little bit of yellows there, okay. Well, I don't have a daughter, I have a niece. And she, you know, and I try to give her the best advice, you know, as an uncle. Okay. Okay, beautiful. Now that railing, excuse me, and the skin has to be made. All right. The skin goes into deep terracotta. Not terracotta, I want to talk. I don't want to talk about colors. I hate explaining colors. Go get your colors and have your own honeymoon with your colors. That's mean it is very personal colors. Just discover them, put them on the canvas, and you say, oh, this is not a recipe program. This is a visit with an artist who tells you everything you wanted to know about art and was afraid to ask. What am I going to say about art lately? Living the life of a star. Okay. Living the life of a star is that of not living in fear. Intimidation is their interest to make you do what they want. Oh, they make you do what they want by intimidating you. Your innocence is their instrument, and as you love and as you lose it, your genius will develop the philosophy to defend your own interest. A star is one that you can see and hear within the presence of light, and they are before their time, therefore they illuminate light years away. Okay. Oh no, my notations fell. Okay, let me just get this in here. Oh, 13 minutes. This is very red for some reason. Why? It's very reddish. I want to go on the edges of it. Why do people have a hard time making other people happy when they know you want them to make you happy? They especially don't want you. I mean, that is the sado narcissist. A sado narcissist is somebody who is very sadistic about the fact that he is found to be attractive. Therefore, they share no beauty that they may possess at all, for they only depend on their exterior. Okay. the sadonarcissist. In other words, a bimbo. 11 minutes. Bimbos are sadonarcissists. I've met a couple of those. Mostly men. Men are mostly sadonarcissists. Men are more sadonarcissistic than females. Okay, that's gonna give me what I want there. The hair, I better hurry up, I have 10 minutes. Let's put a green beret on him. Let's accentuate here. You got to accentuate the positive and eliminate. Okay. His hand. You gotta brown the edges, brown them. Okay, fabulous. The floor, darling, the floor. What are we gonna do with that floor, baby? What color is gonna be that floor? And I think I know. Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, let's make the floor this color. First of all. Solamente una vez. Amen la vida. Solamente una vez. Y nada más. Una vez. I can't remember that song. Solamente una vez en mi vuelto brilló la esperanza. Okay. Only once in my return has, what that song says in Spanish, only once in my return has hope shined its brilliance. La esperanza, la esperanza que ha iluminado mis, the hope that has illuminated my loneliness. It's a very beautiful song. It's a classical song. Okay. Now that is gonna be nice. No, I don't need that one. I need a transparency. And I need another, I think this one. Okay. Now you can go right over his leg because you need to, and then brush off. Okay, that I didn't need. In fact, I don't care too much for it. Okay, I just want to make some planks effects here. Using the terracotta. That I think, okay, that's doing it. Okay, this is in the Degas style. We need to get some kind of whites going on about it, and we gotta brighten him back up there on yellow. Meanwhile, I think that his shoes can be 6 minutes, kind of like a violet or something. They need to be a violet or something, excuse me. Or a purple, I don't know. Yeah, I like his shoes to be like a purple, a violet, with his warm leg warmers here, also the same thing. Okay. It was too wet, baby, too wet. Mm-hmm. Okay, now we have the right consistency. Okay. And the shoes. Uh-huh. Okay. All right, Yeah, that's gonna do just fine. We need some accent somewhere. The hairband he's wearing. Green, I need a green. I need a turquoise or something here. That was a blue. Okay. Okay, that will do for now. Now we gotta get some yellow over here. We need some yellow on here. We need some white. I hate it when it does this. Okay. Okay. Okay, Degas, will you please come here, Degas? I need this man. I need to invoke the spirit of Degas to do this. Now come over here. Okay. Smudge. Okay, now his chest, pectorals, and stuff like that. Get into this. Okay. Needs to be more dry, more dry. Okay, there has to be some yellow about it. He loved yellow tone on the skin. Okay. Uh-huh. Okay, now, up there, forehead. Okay, and a little bit of highlight on the hair there, and on that. And what is missing? I got 1 minute. Oh. A little bit of light on the bar and... Okay. And then crazy Degas lights. Okay, we got 1 minute. We're gonna put crazy Degas lights. Okay, we need some crazy Degas lights. Crazy Degas lights, crazy Degas lights. Okay. Crazy Degas lights. Yeah, more yellowy. Crazy Degas lights. Okay. Crazy Degas lights. Uh-huh. Make it look like pastel. Uh-huh. Seconds only. Okay. Okay, seconds only. Okay. Some crazy Degas lights around here. And darling, I think that's it. Let me sign this. God. TTALI 98. And thanks for joining me today in another program. This is TAli signing off. I'm ready for my close up, Mr. DeMills. Hello and welcome to another program of Painting with TAli, your art collection. Today we're doing a Michelangelo, but a male face. Before I did a Michelangelo in the female style. We're not doing a drawing lesson because we're going to just get into the coloring of it. And what I did, I took the David of Michelangelo's features and then posed him in the type of mannerism that he did for the Sistine Chapel. Let's get started right away. I'm gonna get working on the skin tone. and we're smudging it. Does a great job when you smudge, and then you can also clean better with it too. Okay, now sometimes you get unevenness, and don't worry about the unevenness, just smudge, smudge, smudge. Now this has been set with a mist and workable fixative. Now I'm going to show you, even though I smudge over it like that, we can still work. Okay, getting the tonality that we want. Now, see how I did that line there and then it glowed out? We're gonna do this line here. And that one there. Make it glow out, glow in. Okay. Trying to get an even tone about it. Trying to get even tones about it on the shadows. Okay, on there too. Oh my God, okay. On here. On there. Okay, and we got 21 minutes. I want to get a line on there, defined here in the eyes. And inside the ear. Okay. Oh, here. Oh, I didn't smudge that, put it there, and I didn't smudge it early enough. I hope it's okay. Okay. My head's in the way of it, I'm sure. And over here. Oh, messed up a little bit. Hold on. Okay, that's gonna be probably there for that. And then let's go for some hair, and we got 18, okay. Okay. It just blends wonderful. With your charcoal drawing. Okay, one thing that you can do with your charcoal, now they have this little, these little thin ones, and to make this deeper in tone, yeah, then you spray it. Okay. Put your charcoal away. That's just to give the eyes that deepness there. Okay, now we want to work a little bit with the background here. The inside is going to be kind of a turquoise blue. Okay. More of a green. Okay, and green here too. I wonder how, you know, what pigments did they use at that time in the 15th century when Michelangelo did the Sistine Chapel, because the colors are so bright and beautiful after they were cleansed, you know, after they had been restored. So it's quite interesting. I find it fascinating. Okay. Okay, I'm smudging off a little bit because Okay, let me see. I need to get kind of an orange. There has to be an orange, so this is going that greenish on there. Okay, and we need to smudge it. Oh yes, beautiful. Okay, we need to smudge it. Now, we need some violet because that's the inside of it. I don't want to talk. We need to smudge it. Yes, we need some violet. Okay, we need to smudge it. Violet there. We need to smudge it. Good, we didn't get into the skin. Okay. Uh-huh, very, very nice. Okay, more watery because it won't draw. Okay. Uh-huh. Effects in here. Okay. Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Though purple isn't the best. Okay, but it does give you some type of effect. Yeah, we need some there. Okay. And okay. Now, we need some dark brown somehow. And we got to, okay, where's that other one? Okay. Okay, I need some dark, deep brown for the locks. The locks need some deepness. The locks need some deepness in the locks. It really needs some deepness. The eyes, trying to get it into a amber tone of eyes, okay. The locks need some deepness. Okay. 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 All right, that seems to do the trick. Now we need some orange, some beautiful orange. And that rest of it is blue. What kind of orange did I use? Oh, more yellowy orange. Aha, oh yes. Gorgeous. Beautiful. Beautiful. And it's folding out. Oh yeah, how gorgeous. Okay, and this is orange here too. Because it's, I don't know, some kind of veil that, you know, Michelangelo put these veils on, these sheets flying around the place very beautifully on his characters of the 16th Chapel. And that is the outside. So I think it should have a very bright color that distinguishes it different. Which one? Blue or yellow? Probably blue. Probably blue, just blue. Very cobalt, this blue. Hold on a second. No, don't want it, very cobalt. I don't know what it is with the cobalt pigment. I just don't dig it. Okay. Turquoise. Turquoise. No, you know what? It's going to be yellow, and you can erase all of it completely. Uh-huh. It's going to be yellow. It's going to be yellow. It's got a brand new virgin brush for it. Uh-huh, it's going to be yellow. Yeah, yellow's doing it. Yellow's doing it. Okay, yellow is doing it. Mm-hmm. But that yellow needs maybe like a tint. Like a tint, not too exactly. Not too exactly. Not too exactly. And Okay, fabulous. Now the eyebrows need to be done somehow. I'm using the same color that I used for the hair. Okay. Do we need to smudge it? To transparentize it a little bit? Okay. Okay, and the lips need to have just a little bit of tint to it. Hold on. Okay. Okay. All right, hold on. Okay, the lips are coming in beautifully. The eyes do need a little bit more of definition. Okay. What is it when it doesn't paint? Definition the nostril. Okay. Okay. Shoulder here. Definition and blend. Definition and blend on that. Oh, there's a rubber band or something. I don't want to talk. I really don't want to talk. Oh, the talking TV artist. Oh, I'm not a talking TV artist. Okay, beautifully. Now let me see. Let me look down here. And we also need some white. We're at the final stretch here, and we need the white lights. Oh my God, I need somebody to screw these things. We need the final white lights, and what brush will we do the final white lights with? Okay, we have one here. All right, the final white lights. Final white lights inside here, the eye. And of course it has a little, that one was on the wrong spot. Okay. Okay, that's fine. And the lips will have this a little bit that. And the locks, these locks do need some highlight. And that highlight, I'm gonna have to blend it in with that hair color. don't have time to screw it. I don't have time to screw it. Okay. It's one color here, it's another one when you apply. Okay. Okay. All right, what do we got? Oh, seconds only, I gotta get out of here. Okay. All right, well, it's gonna have to be that for now, darling. You see, it's always going to be me, the canvas, the cameras, and all you wonderful people out there in the suburbs. This is TAli signing off. I'm ready for my close-up, Mr. Mills.